At least 76 people have been killed as a crackdown on protesters in Iran intensifies. The country has seen nearly 2 weeks of unrest, sparked by the death of a 22-year-old woman in police custody. Mahsa Amini was arrested earlier this month for allegedly breaching the country's strict rules on the wearing of hijab. She collapsed after being taken to a detention center and later died. Security forces are accused of using disproportionate force and live ammunition to break up protests in various cities. More than 1,000 people, including journalists, have been arrested. Typhoon Noru unleashes heavy rains and damaging winds in Vietnam. High-rise buildings shook in the central city of Da Nang from strong gusts of wind that uprooted trees and tore off roofs and houses. Large-scale power outages have also been reported, and Vietnam evacuated hundreds of thousands of people ahead of Noru's landfall. Almost half of the country's airports were shut, and schools and offices were closed across several central provinces. The southern Chinese provinces of Hainan and Guangdong now bracing for Noru. Emergency measures were activated Tuesday as the storm approaches. Emergency personnel have been told to reinforce buildings, while thousands of fishing boats have been barred from sailing as a precaution. We begin in Cuba, where the powerful Hurricane Ian leaves a trail of destruction. Power supply in the country, home to 11 million people, was cut off Tuesday as the storm pummeled the western part of the island. Two are reported dead. Ian also prompted 40,000 individuals to evacuate across the Pinar del Río province, which bore the brunt of the storm. The death toll due to Typhoon Karding climbs to 10. The new fatalities were reported in Baliwag, Bulacan and Tanay, Rizal, both due to drowning. Eight others remain missing. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council says damage to infrastructure has reached over 23 million pesos, while damage to agriculture is over at 100 million pesos. But based on the Agriculture Department's tally, the typhoon left 1.3 billion pesos in damage as flooding hit rice-producing provinces. Families of the fallen rescuers in Bulacan support calls for better benefits for first responders. One of the five victims was Narciso Calayag Jr., and his brother shared Narciso was just a volunteer, which means he was not entitled to a salary whenever he joined rescue efforts. The wife of another victim, Gerson Resurreccion, meanwhile shared her husband was a rescuer for 15 years. Both of them believe rescuers should be properly compensated because they are putting their own lives at risk to save others.
Hindi lang po maging regular. Na sana po magkaroon po tayo ng batas para po sa mga responder, first responder, volunteers, yung risk na sinasagupa po nila. COVID na yan, yung aksidente na yan, sa pagdating sa tubig, earthquake, lahat, sakop nila.
Napakalaking bagay po para po sa mga rescuer. Kung magbibigyan po sana ng sapat na tulong ng lahat ng ating mga rescuer para po magampanan yung kanilang tungkulin. Dahil hindi po biro ang mga rescuer. Talaga pong sinusugal nilang kanilang buhay para po makapagligtas ng iba.
The chair of the Philippine Senate's Migrant Workers Committee wants criminal charges against two recruitment agencies following the death of a Filipino worker in Saudi Arabia. That call made against Gulf Synergy Employment and the Saudi Arabian-owned Manabe Recruitment Agency during a Senate hearing on discrimination against overseas Filipino workers. Senator Rafi Tulfo said domestic helper Jovelin Tang Andres committed suicide after she was hurt and forced by her recruiter to abort her baby. The president of Gulf Synergy Employment admitted lapses in monitoring the situation of Andres. This did not sit well with Senator Tulfo.
Sir, honestly, ngayon ko lang nalaman na ganun ang palang istorya sa kwento niyo, sir. Honestly, wala po kaming alam na buntis or what.
Are you stupid or you just trying to be stupid? Sorry, sir. I'm not gonna accept that kind of answer. Hindi mo alam, ngayon mo lang nalaman?
Wala po kasing report na natanggap mula sa FRA na Manabi.
The Migrant Workers Department says the licenses of the two recruitment agencies involved in the case have been suspended.